Good morning, everybody. How are you today? We miss you. We're so glad that you're here checking out these nine onlines today. And this morning, we are going to talk about fear in uncertain times. I'm sure you are just like I am. I'm kind of tired of this, but it's still uncertainty as far as how long is this going to last? How long will the restrictions be upon us? And sometimes if I'm honest with you, thinking, God, when is this all going to end? Are you here with us? And so we want to talk a little bit about that today, about fear in uncertain times. So I want to start by sharing a story with you from when I was a little boy. I was on vacation in North Carolina with my family. It was a hot summer day, and I remember us going to this place to cool off, and they called it Sliding Rock. All it was is this little kind of waterfall that the water went gently over this kind of big rock down into a pool at the bottom. And I remember it was, again, hot outside, we're sweating, you get into this water, and it is mountain or spring mountain water. Very cold. And everybody in my family's going in, they're having a great time, and just remember them, and they're swimming out, it was no big deal. So I just trying to get used to the water. Remember, it was very cold. And so I take my turn, I slide down this rock, and man, when I hit that water, that pool of water at the bottom, I immediately go into shock. It takes my breath away. And my arms immediately, so they stop working too. And so all this is happening so fast. So I'm trying to swim doggy paddle. I can't move. My body's almost locked up. I can barely breathe because, again, it's so cold. I can just still remember this to this day. I'm looking out at my family. My brother's the closest one to me. And I'm looking at him saying, Jimmy, Jim. And it's not coming out because I can't take a deep, big breath here. And again, I'm doing this and I'm noticing the water is getting closer and closer and I am going under. I know that's going to happen. If nothing happens, they're going to look back and they're not going to see me. They're going to have to dive in to find me. And I thought I was in really big trouble. I just remember the fear that was over me. In this uncertain time, I had no idea. Are they going to help me or not? Are they going to realize what's going on or not? And so finally, I'm doing this and the water's right about here. I'm barely getting air in. When my brother turns around, he sees me. He comes back, takes me, gets me out of the water, and everything has kind of ended up being fine. But I'll never forget that fear, the feelings of just that uncertainty, like panic rushing over me, just thinking, I need a savior. I need somebody to help me in that moment. And God used my brother to save me. I have no doubt if he didn't turn around, my family left me, I would have been under that water in no time. And so today we want to look at Daniel chapter 10. And when we come to this chapter, Daniel has this vision of this man that is sent by God to answer to one of Daniel's prayers. And one of the things he says to him, to Daniel in verse 12 is this. He says, don't be afraid, Daniel. Since the first day you began to pray for understanding and to humble yourself before God, your request has been heard in heaven. I have come to answer your prayer. And what I love about this is that as we see this here in the Old Testament, and there's tons of examples in the New Testament, that God loves us. He loves you and he answers prayer. Daniel, a faithful saint to God, was praying out to him and he answered his prayer. And then in verse 19, he tells Daniel again, he says, don't be afraid. He says, for you are very precious to God. Wow, that's great news. Peace, be encouraged, be strong. And so today, as we hear these words, let these words wash over you that this is what God is saying to you and to me. Listen, don't be afraid. In these uncertain times, we don't know if it's going to be another week, another month, what's going to happen, but God does. He is in control. Yet he loves you. He hears us when we pray to him. And so let's be encouraged. Let's be strong. Let's have faith that God is in control no matter what's going to happen. Thanks for being with us today. Have a great day. See ya.